Before we demonstrate overlay networking with Open vSwitch, we will first measure the network throughput of the flat network to test fabric and stack. The demo itself will feature two hypervisors connected through a pair of 40 gigabit network cards. One hypervisor is running two VMs, which will generate 20 parallel TCP streams each. The TCP streams are distributed to four VMs running on a second hypervisor. After testing connectivity, we measure the throughput from bridge to bridge, which in this case is 34 gigabit per second. This is just below wire speed. We are able to close the gap and reach 40 gigabit wire speed by binding both the net server and netperf process to the NUMA node to which the NIC is connected to. In order to measure VM performance, a script is utilized to start all netperf sessions in parallel and sum up the results. You can find a reference to the script together with other material at the end of the video. To simplify this demo, we have already bound all the QEMU and vHost threads to the appropriate NUMA node, just like we did for netperf before. The performance we achieve is still close to wire speed, even considering the now added virtualization overhead. We are now going to convert both bridges to use VXLAN encapsulation to implement overlay networking. For this purpose, we are removing the uplink ports from the bridges and replacing them with a VXLAN tunnel. This particular NIC model requires a non-standard UDP destination port to be used in order for the offloading engine to be effective. As we rerun the performance benchmark, we notice weak performance. This is due to the added VXLAN encapsulation overhead that causes packet sizes to exceed the MTU of the physical NIC, which causes fragmentation. We will reduce the MTU of the internal bridge port to account for that. Another option would be to increase the MTU of your fabric, but we will leave it at the standard 1500 byte for this test. Performance on the bridge level is now back to almost wire speed. The gap is explained by the additional VXLAN overhead, which eats away some payload. Rerunning the VM benchmark results in 32.6 gigabit, which translates to more than 4 gigabyte of data leaving the NIC per second.